Welcome everyone. Today we are going to start with the sum number 3 of NCRT, not for profit organization. In this sum, we have to prepare income and expenditure account. Income and expenditure always stands with all the revenue nature expenses and revenue nature income. First, we are going to read the sum. Now here they had not given us receipts and payments account, they had just given us the information, and from that information only we are going to pick up and draw income and expenditure account. I'm switching towards the sum. Have a look on that. Fees collected including 80,000 in account of previous year, rupees 5,20,000. Fees for the year outstanding. So both are related to fees only, that we will discuss later on when we are solving the sum. But it is highlighting that something is outstanding of current year and something is outstanding of previous year. Then comes your salaries paid including 5,000 on account of previous year and salary outstanding at the end of the year. Same pattern, salaries and expenses, and they are outstanding for the current year and outstanding for the previous year. Then comes your entertainment expenses standing with rupees 3,000. Standing with rupees 8,000, tournament expenses 25,000, meeting expenses, traveling expenses, and then comes your purchase of books and periodicals, including rupees 31,000 for purchase of books. Now, books and periodicals both are given together, but books is capital nature expenses, and periodicals are revenue nature. So, we have to deal with that in the later prospects. Then comes your rent, postage and telegrams and telephones, printing and stationery, and donation received. So this is a scenario of the sum. Now we will switch on to the solution of the sum. So switching towards the preparation of income and expenditure account. Under this, one by one, we will pick up the items and we will do the adjustment. So very first thing, fees collected. Now fees collected itself is what it is, a income for us. So fees collected will be on the income side, credit side, that is 5,20,000. Under that, they had mentioned that fees for the year outstanding is 30,000, but at the same time fees for the previous year is 80,000. So 80,000, what is there of the previous year, we are going to minus it, and at the same time of outstanding for the current year you are going to add. So ultimately fees is coming out as 4,70,000. Then comes your salary, salaries and expenses, and it will come on the debit side. So come to your salary first. There you write down 2 salary in the inner column, 68,000. There you will see a salary outstanding is 3,000 mentioned over here, and at the same time including 5,000 on account of previous year is given. So outstanding we are going to add 3,000 rupees, and previous year 5,000 we are going to minus. So this will give you outer figure as 66,000. Then comes your expenses of entertainment expenses. It's an expenses itself, so 2 entertainment expenses on the debit side you will see. Then comes your tournament expenses, then meeting expenses, then traveling expenses. These all items are without adjustment, so we are directly going to transfer that. Then comes your purchase of books and periodicals, including 31,000 for purchase of books, that is 40,000. You will see 40,000 is total expenses, but of which 31,000 is for books. So only 9,000 will be transferred for the daily routine, that is yearly expenses of periodicals. So I have taken out 9,000 by writing here 40,000 minus 31,000. Then comes your rent as a routine expenses, that is revenue nature, postage, telegrams and telephone revenue expenses, printing and stationery revenue expenses, and donation received is a income. Now no specific donation is mentioned, so it will be on the credit side as general donation. Though this way your all the posting is over. Now we are going to start with the total. So we have total apne karsu banne side nu total rough ma karvan. After that you have to find out, you will see that credit side total is more. Now from credit side you have to deduct all the items of debit side and then minus it, and you will find the difference of 3,23,000. Answer in the textbook is 3,07,000, which is wrong. यू हेव टू गो विथ 3,27,000. थोड़ा थोड़ा सामना आंसर रॉन्ग है, पर आप आ जे छे ते करव पड़ सब. सो अल्टिमेटली यू गेट द सरप्लस एक्सेस ऑफ इनकम ओवर एक्सपेन्डिचर 3,23,000. दैट्स ऑल फॉर दिस पर्टिक्युलर सम. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद द नेक्स्ट सम, दैट इज सम नंबर 4 इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो.